Hello, and welcome to TI Precision Labs. If you have ever designed or considered designing a USB Type-C system, you have probably run into the DisplayPort, or DP, Alt-Mode. You might be wondering what is DP Alt-Mode, and how it is related to the USB Type-C system. This presentation gives you a quick overview of the DP Alt-Mode. Before we begin, if you are not familiar with DisplayPort, please refer to the earlier TIPL What is DisplayPort DP presentation for more information. So what is DP Alt Mode? To begin, DP Alt Mode is an alternate or alt mode which allows the transfer of non-USB data over a USB-C connector. An example of DP Alt Mode includes the increasingly popular DisplayPort or DP video interface. A USB-C port capable of transferring DisplayPort signals is either called a USB-C DisplayPort or DP Alt Mode. These ports allow you to connect video sources, like PCs and Blu-ray players, and display devices, like TVs and monitors, that support DisplayPort to each other via their USB-C ports to broadcast high-definition video. Please note that DP Alt Mode, or DisplayPort Alternate Mode, is not the same as USB-C. USB-C is a connector type, while DP Alt Mode is a specific feature that is supported by some USB-C appliances. It is important to note that not all USB-C cables or devices support DP Alt Mode. Both the cable and the device must support DP Alt Mode in order for this feature to work. Next, let's look at a general block diagram of a DP Alt Mode design. We will start on the source side. For this particular block diagram, we have a USB host that has VBUS, USB 2, and USB 3. Next, we have a DP source, a GPU in this case, that has the main link, AUX, and HPD signals. In order to support the DP Alt Mode implementation, a power delivery, or PD, controller is needed. On the source side, the multiplexer, or MUX, takes a USB and DP lanes and switches them to the appropriate high-speed lanes of the USB-C connector. On the sync side, we also have a PD controller that will negotiate with the PD controller on the source side over the CC bus to support DP Alt Mode implementation. On the sync side, the MUX will take the four high-speed lanes from the USB-C connectors as input and then distribute the signal to the correct USB or DP sync. The key highlights of a DP Alt Mode implementation are an added transaction layer, the CC log, to communicate USB-C orientation, DP Alt Mode, and assignment between the source and the sync. USB-C transmitter and receiver pairs are repurposed to carry main link lanes. SBUs are used to carry sideband traffic over the AUX positive and AUX negative lanes. HPD is propagated through PD messaging over the CC lane. And multiple pin assignments, depending on the mode of operation to be supported by the alternate mode, downstream facing port, or upstream facing port systems. Next, let's describe the general flow behind a DP Alt Mode implementation beginning in a USB connection. First, a USB connection is detected via the CC pins of a USB-C connection. After this, USB-C port role negotiation begins, with the downstream facing port and the upstream facing port roles being determined. After this, USB-C power delivery negotiation begins. At default, the power delivered via the VBUS pin is 5 volts at 500 milliamps. Through battery charging 1.2, BC 1.2, or USB PD, this can be further negotiated to a desired power over VBUS that is beyond what is default. Initially, the source will advertise its capabilities, while the sync will detect its capabilities. Additionally, at this time, power or data role swap will be done here. After this, USB enumeration will begin. If connecting to a hub, both USB 3 and USB 2 enumeration will be done at the same time. At this point, if DP Alt Mode negotiation has been completed, then DP link training will begin to enable the DP link. After this, USB and DP channels are ready for data and video transfer over Type-C. Various pin assignments on the USB Type-C connector are defined when sending and receiving DisplayPort signaling. Since a USB-C port can be connected to a USB-C or DP port, pin assignments are created to properly define the physical mapping of the DP main link lanes to the USB-C connector. For source side or downstream facing port, assignment C is required while assignment D is optional. The difference between assignment C and assignment D is that assignment C supports 4 DP lanes while assignment D supports 2 DP lanes. For USB-C port to DisplayPort, assignment E support is required. For the sync side or upstream facing port, assignment C is required while assignment D is optional. The difference between assignment C and D is that assignment C supports 4 DP lanes while assignment D supports 2 DP lanes. For DP to USB-C port, assignment E support is required. This graph shows the DP main link and aux mapping to the USB-C for the normal plug orientation of assignment C. The graph on the left shows the assignment C lane mapping for the downstream facing port or the source, while the graph on the right shows the assignment C mapping for the upstream facing port or the sink. Please note the lane mapping difference between the source and the sink. This graph shows the DP main link and aux mapping to the USB-C for the normal plug orientation of assignment E. Please note that while the mapping of main link and aux is the same between assignment C and E on the source side, the main link lane order, polarity, and aux polarity are different between the assignment C and E on the sync side. This graph shows the DP main link and aux mapping to the USB-C for the flipped plug orientation of assignment C. This graph on the left shows the assignment C lane mapping for the downstream facing port or the source, while the graph on the right shows the assignment C mapping for the upstream facing port or the sink. Again, please note the lane mapping difference between the source and the sink. This graph shows the DP main link and aux mapping to the USB-C for the flipped plug orientation of assignment E. Please note that while the mapping of main link and aux is the same between assignment C and E on the source side, the main link lane order, polarity, and aux polarity are different between the assignment C and assignment E on the sync side. Next, let's take a short quiz regarding some features of DP alt mode. 1. Aux positive and aux negative sideband signal is carried over the CC bus. 2. DP alt mode can support USB only, USB and DP, and DP only. 3. USB-C and USB-E are different on the source side. 4. Assignment C and assignment D are the same on the sync side. Please take a second to pause the video and think about your answer before unpausing for the answer. 1. Aux positive and aux negative sideband signals are carried over the CC bus. This is false. SBUs are used to carry sideband traffic over aux positive and aux negative, not CC bus. 2. DP alt mode can support USB only, USB and DP, and DP only. This is true. These can all be supported in DP alt mode. 3. Assignment C and assignment E are different on the source side. This is false. While these assignments are the same on the source side, the main link lane order, polarity, and aux polarity are both different for these assignments on the sync side. 4. Assignment C and assignment D are same on the sync side. This is true. Thank you for joining us. If you want more information about DisplayPort, please check out the other videos surrounding DisplayPort in our TIPL series of videos.